Speak the speech, I pray you, as I pronounced it to you trippingly on the tongue. But if you mouth it, as many of your players do, I had as lief the town crier spoke my lines. Nor do not saw the air too much with your hand thus, but use all gently, for in the very torrent, tempest, and as I may say, whirlwind of passion, you must beget and acquire a temperance that may give it smoothness. Oh, it offends me to the soul to see a robustious, periwig-pated fellow tear a passion to tatters, to very rags, to split the ears of groundlings who, for the most part, are capable of nothing but inexplicit dumb shows and noise. I would have a fellow whipped for overdoing termagant. And out Herod's Herod, pray you, avoid it. Be not too tame, neither. Let your discretion be your tutor. Suit the action to the word, and the word to the action. And for this special observance, oh, play not the modesty of nature. For anything so o'erdone is from the purpose of playing, whose end, both at the first and now, was and is, to hold, as it were, the mirror up to nature, to show virtue her own feature, scorn her own image, and the very body and age of time, his form and pressure. Now, this o'erdone, or come tardy off, and though it make the unskilled laugh, cannot but make the judicious grieve, the centre of the which one, surely, in your allowance, must owe away a whole theatre of others. Oh, reform it altogether. Let those that speak your clowns speak no more than is set down for them. For there be of them those that will laugh, and set on a whole quantity of barren spectators to laugh too, though then in the meantime the very question of the play be then to be considered. Now that's villainous, and shows a piteous ambition in the fool that uses it. Go, make you ready.
Ready, 5, 4, 3.